And indeed, joining me now to talk about the high rate of invalid signatures for the top two primary initiative is Joe Yuhas, a spokesman for the Open Government, Open Election campaign, the group that is backing the initiative. Good to see you again.
Hey, Ted.
Thanks for joining us. We just heard from Karen Osborne here, County Elections Director. It sounds as though you guys just had a big batch of invalid signatures. What's going on?
Well, what a fine job Karen and all the staff do at the Maricopa County Elections Department. They have a monumental task to complete in a 10-day time period to take that sample and conduct an analysis and determine, because we are the largest, Maricopa County is the largest county in the state, whether this measure moves forward. We take issue. We take issue because, first of all, we conducted our own validity check as we gathered petitions over a much more extended period of time, October of last year. That validity check matches all of the other counties in the state, except for Maricopa County. There's some anomaly here, and we're not quite sure what it is, although actually in the last, say, 24 hours, we've discovered. In that sample that Karen talked about, the 4,314 voters' signatures, we found an 80-year-old woman who was deemed to be, that signature was deemed to be invalid because she didn't put a 1 in front of the 2 for 2012. We found indications of voters that were, the signatures that were declared invalid because they weren't registered to vote. Well, the fact of the matter is the first 80 that we checked, we found 13 of those that were actually registered voters. We're actually deploying our volunteers now across the county from Wickenburg to Queen Creek who are getting signed affidavits from voters in which the election officials have said that signature doesn't match their voter registration form. They're signing an additional document saying, I did in fact sign that petition. This, we believe, is going to earn us back the signatures we need to qualify for the ballot.
And yet the process, according to the elections director, nothing has changed here. The guidelines aren't any more strict than they used to be. If you put a one, if you don't put the one there, you put the one in the wrong place. Those apparently have not been counted in the past. The anomaly, she says, exists as well with other. How do you explain Coconino County and Pima County having such disparaging numbers?
Disparate numbers, I should say. My chart here shows that the validation rate, again, keep in mind that Maricopa County's numbers are at 67%. Coconino County's validation rate is 86.9%. Pima County's is at 77.9%. In fact, the statewide average is nearly 79%, Ted, and that's what we don't understand. Why is it that there is a 12% difference, 12 percentage point difference between Maricopa County and the rest of the state? Why is it that a higher number of voters are disenfranchised as a result?
What's the answer?
Well, we're going to find out. We're conducting an analysis now of the results of that sample that Karen mentioned, at 4,314 signatures that were deemed to be invalid. We're preparing to take action. That action may very well be, once again, going to the courts. We're accustomed to that. The history of the Open Elections, Open Government Initiative to date has been, you know, one legal impediment after another. The lobbyists and the political bosses don't like this measure. And so we're ready to tackle the next legal challenge.
So with one of three signatures ruled invalid here in Maricopa County, one in four having no registration records, they can't even find the registration records of these folks. And again, nothing seems to have changed. According to the elections director, there's nothing unusual here in terms of how the verification process was done. What do you tell the judge?
Well, Ted, I can't speak for previous campaigns that may have failed to qualify because of whatever criteria was used. I can only talk about our situation and what we're finding. Again, the issue of unregistered voters. We only had the opportunity to secure these records yesterday morning at around 10 a.m. We only had the opportunity to check 80 of the so-called unregistered voter signatures. We found 13 registered voters in just that group of 80. As Karen pointed out, you know, most of these are allegedly to be unregistered voters, but we're finding, frankly, that the registration is actually there. So we're going to continue to this process that we've started, which ultimately I believe is going to lead to action in the court.
Who did collect these petitions?
The campaign did, a collection of paid and volunteers. But frankly, the campaign bears responsibility here, a campaign that's led by some of our state's most respected business and community leaders who recognize that hyperpartisanship is bringing our governmental institutions really sometimes to a grinding halt. So we can't, you know, take our eye off the ball here. Our goal is to not only put this measure on the ballot, but also change the way our elections are conducted so that we don't continue down this road of hyperpartisanship.
And I asked who collected the signatures because while you were also looking at the county elections department, what they did, how they did it, those particular formulas and processes, I'm wondering if you're asking the folks who did the petition gathering, did you do this right? Did you just walk up and take? I mean, are you investigating that angle as well? And
not only now, but frankly, over the course of our petition drive. I mentioned earlier, we conducted our own internal validation process. We didn't just check 5%, Ted. We checked almost 35%, again, statewide. And we're finding that our internal validation rate is matching the 14 other counties in the state. The only exception is Maricopa County. We need to find out why.
And you are going to court?
As we continue to gather the information, as we review, again, we just had an opportunity yesterday to secure the report from Maricopa County. But I think we're reasonably confident that's the direction we're going.
I would say that has to happen pretty quickly, doesn't it?
It does, because next week, Karen and all the election officials across the state begin their process of preparing for the November election, the printing of ballots, the publicity pamphlet, you name it. So we have a tight time frame here, and that's why we're working as hard as we are to qualify for the ballot.
All right, Joe, good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ted.